LWEB-900 now supports the integration of VivoTech and third-party cameras supporting the ONVIF protocol. Camera objects can be added in the folder Network Devices. To manage a large number of devices, they can be grouped in subfolders. The LWEB-900 server supports an online network scan on the local subnet. During this scan, the LWEB-900 server searches for IP cameras and detects their properties. LOYTEC devices can now be discovered automatically instead of adding them manually. Select the folder Network Devices or a subfolder and choose New Discover Devices from the context menu. This feature allows accessing multiple LWEB-900 servers located at different sites within a single LWEB-900 client. It is possible to create a common graphical view showing data from the different servers. Devices, alarms, and users can be managed across the sites. To enable this feature, the LWEB-900 MS license needs to be installed on each LWEB-900 server. A new type of reports has been implemented. The measurement and verification report allows quantifying savings delivered by an energy conservation measure. It displays the measured consumption during the reporting period and compares it to the prediction by the model. The navigation and object list view now displays the folder description next to the folder name. This is especially useful for LEOP and LDALI devices. A new file format for graphical views has been implemented. The LWEB3 file format allows the client application to load only resources that are currently displayed. Therefore, graphical views with a large number of pages are possible. Two new system registers have been added to track the resources usage of the LWEB-900 server process: LWEB-900 server CPU load and LWEB-900 server memory usage. Also, a number of improvements have been implemented in the user management dialog, like sorting users and groups, or automatically scroll to newly created users. It is now possible to create a project backup not only in the LWEB-900 server UI, but also in the LWEB-900 client UI. The possibility to send a message from the LWEB-900 server UI was introduced. The user interface of the LWEB-900 client and server was improved. It is now possible to magnify or shrink views by double-clicking on their title bar. To reduce the memory usage, views are automatically unloaded if they are in the background for more than 15 minutes and the memory consumption is more than 900 MB. task that can take a long time, for example a firmware update, can now be executed in the background. A number of changes has been implemented to improve security. Support of TLS 1.2 protocols of the HTTPS communication with the LWEB-900 server. Check if default admin password is used and propose to change it. An icon indicating a secure or unsecure connection has been added to the drop-down list of the project connections in the login dialog. The security level of each connected client is displayed in the LWEB-900 server statistics dialog. When creating a new certificate, the lifetime can be configured. The support for multi-domain IP certificates has been added. Also, additional new features were implemented. New features on alarming, the Spanish language support, changes in the parameter and web browser view, and a better LStudio integration. For more information, have a look at the LWEB-900 user manual.